fucking tarnation! Anarchy!
I don't even know what that means, but I love it!
Well, as we've just seen, clearly Walker and Texas Ranger behaved in an oppositional manner. They were supposed to be in Sunday school, and yet they were found running through the backyard with screams for anarchy.
This type of behavior is characteristic of the oppositional defiant disorder. This disorder is characterized by patterns of negativity, hostility, and defiant behavior lasting at least 6 months, where four or more of the following traits are present. Frequent loss of temper, frequent arguments with adults, frequent deliberate defiance of the rules or requests that an adult may ask, and the deliberate annoyance of others on a frequent basis, as well as
frequently blaming others for his or her mistakes, easily annoyed by others, frequently being angry or resentful, and frequent spiteful or vindictive behavior.
We have monitored these children and will compare their behavior to criteria established in the DSM-IV-TR. Now, we were fortunate enough to catch these children at a family dinner, so let's go ahead and take a look.
Boys, how was school today?
I threw a bunch of Grandpa Chip's war medals off the bridge.
That sounds like a good day. Texas Ranger, how about you?
Well, the teacher asked me what was the capital of North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
I said Washington, D.C.
Bingo.
Nice.
She said, no, you're wrong. I said, you got a lumpy butt. She got mad at me and yelled at me, and I pissed in my pants. And I never did change my pee pants all day. I'm still sitting in my dirty pee pants.
Walker mentions throwing his grandfather Chip's war medals off a bridge in a spiteful manner just to annoy his grandfather.
And then Texas Ranger tells his teacher she has a lumpy bottom all because she said his incorrect answer was wrong. He then pees his pants when she gets angry and yells at him. In an act of defiance, he sits in his dirty pee pants all the way through dinner.
Now let's take a look at some more footage from this same family dinner.
I can't hold my tongue. These kids are my grandchildren, and you are raising them wrong. They are terrible boys.
Shut up, Chip, or I'll go ape shit on your ass. I'm going to scissor kick you in the back of the head.
Yeah,
turn up the heat.
Go on and get some, boys.
Come on.
I'm 10 years old, but I'll beat your ass. Chip, I'm going to come at you like a spider monkey.
Like a spider monkey. Go on.
Chip, you brought this on, man.
Greatest generation my ass. Tom Brokaw is a punk.
What is wrong with you?
Chip, I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew.
I love that.
You gonna let your sons talk to their grandfather like that? I'm their elder.
I sure as hell am, Chip. I love the way they're talking to you. Because they're winners. Winners get to do what they want. Hell, you're just a bag of bones.
Here we see the boys. They easily lose their temper, and they verbally threaten their elder in a resentful manner. To make matters even worse, Walker and Texas Ranger's parents, they encourage this type of defiant behavior. This could be a result of the defiance that Ricky Bobby shows himself.
Walker and Texas Ranger are 11 and 7 years old respectively. And though this type of behavior is not uncommon for children this age, the rate at which it occurs is cause for alarm. According to the DSM-IV-TR, we will most likely diagnose this as a case of oppositional defiant disorder for four reasons. These behaviors cause social and academic functioning impairment. These behaviors occur outside of the normal development for children this age. These behaviors recur in a pattern towards authority figures, as well as these behaviors are not exclusive to one point in time or context.
Since we have established a diagnosis, let's discuss some treatment. A typical treatment would first involve conducting a structured or semi-structured interview to fully explore the family's history, the symptoms of ODD, as well as comorbid problems that may be present.
A couple of possible treatment options here are problem solving and skills training programs, which teach children how to solve problems in a logical and predictable manner. One setback to this type of training is that it is rather time-consuming, with an average requirement of 20 sessions.
Another effective treatment is parent management training. This allows the parents to establish a contingency management program at the home, which makes for better positive interactions between the parent and the child. By maintaining effective timeouts, reinforcing positive behaviors with good praise, as well as maintaining schedules and sticking to them. This program allows the child to know what is expected of them and what will happen if their defiance is resumed.
We see a version of parent management training here from Lucy Bobby, the children's grandmother. Let's have a look.
Jar.
Mama?
No,
Mama.
Ricky, no. I will not have my grandbabies acting like shiftless, wild hobos. All right, now you boys listen up, and you listen good. Now, I am declaring Granny Law, and if you do not obey Granny Law, I will paint your back porch red.
Sorry, Granny, but you're shit out of luck.
We make the rules, not you.
Mm-hmm.
Hey! Ouch!
You're gonna break us like wild horses, ain't you?
It's the beginning of a new age.
Lucy Bobby has obviously become fed up with the children's behavior and takes matters into her own hands.
Here's part of the training, trash pickup.
Get this highway clean.
I gotta tell you, Granny, this blows.
How much more of this?
I don't know. How many more times are you gonna toss me the radio in the bathtub?
Now we're getting somewhere. She continues by removing the negative devices in the children's lives and providing them with more positive activities to partake in.
Now some of you would live through me and light me up and throw away the key.
Hey, Ricky!
Just find a place
to hide
away, hope that I'll just go away.
After much hard work, Lucy Bobby is able to turn her rebellious grandchildren into two fine, upstanding young citizens.
Son, that was lovely.
What a lovely meal.
It sure is.
It certainly does look delicious.
I gotta tell you, this is about a damn perfect even right now.
It is, isn't it? Mmm. You know what we should do? Every week, we should come back to this Applebee's and sit at this table and have a family meal.
It's a great idea, Mama.
And order the same stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
And I would be delighted, Reese, if you would accompany me to ballroom dancing on Tuesday nights.
Tuesday night?
It's a lot of fun. I think you'd have a good time.
How's everybody doing over here?
Dolly is so good.
It's
really
so good.
Delicious.
You know, I hate to be a pain, darling, but I asked for no onions on my bourbon steak.
Oh, I am so sorry. I thought you asked
for
onions.
Maybe don't interrupt me.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
Yeah, well, I think you did mean to, and I also think that you meant to put the damn onions on my steak.
Okay, Reese.
Grandfather, can't we resolve this conflict without anger?
I'm a veteran!
Dad!
Get a diabetic!
Dad! Why are you doing this?
Applebee's has rats! I found a whole rat in my Cobb salad!
Well, that concludes a successful diagnosis and treatment of Walker Bobby and Texas Ranger Bobby.
Now, Reese Bobby, on the other hand, he's a whole nother story.
Thank you all for joining us.
Woo!
Woo!
Woo! Ow!
If you ain't first, you're last. You know what I'm talking about? That phrase is trademarked, not to be used outside the tradition of Ricky Bobby Inc.